Hey, what's going on? This is Michael Love and Freedom. Got another video for you that may help you here moving forward in your search. Maybe you're looking for a place to rent or maybe rent to own, and you're in dire need of a rental property. Just to inform you guys, you have to be careful. There are a lot of scams going on via online media and a lot of fake postings about rental properties. And I wanted to be the first. I'm sure you heard it before. I won't say I want to be the first, but I did want to enlighten you guys so you will be kept on your toes about certain scams that's been going on. And it don't only happen in the United States. It happens as well over here in Mexico. And the reason why I say that, there have been in the past where such as here in Mexico, a person may have owned their house, built their home, and have a property here. And they may no longer reside over here, but they live in the United States or other parts of Mexico. So what they have been doing is posting the ad saying that they the owner of the home, or they may be overseer or management of the home or landlord of the home. And while the person is not away or don't have anyone checking on their property, they are gaining some type of financial gain from this property, and it's not even theirs, or they don't even have authorization to be in that home as well. And they posted on the internet about deals that may sound too good to be true. And guess what? With the way the market is now, with the cost of inflation, cost of living is going up. If it sounds too good to be true, then more likely it is not true. So I wanted to touch bases with you guys. I'm still seeing a lot of these scams. I ran across an issue today I seen a posting, and I was looking at, I'm always looking at like different properties or investments or stuff like that. And I saw this home in Arizona. And they was like selling a home, and then also they had it with the option to buy, rent to own, or option to buy. And I just reached out of curiosity, sent an email. Well, I sent a message to them. It was on the marketplace on Facebook. And right away, they responded a bit and wasn't even professional about how they were corresponding. And right off, like, I asked them, is this the amount to rent? And they said, well, yeah, you can start renting first, and then we'll talk about buying it, if you want to buy it. So I was like, okay, is there a way I can come see the home, like get a tour of the home? And they said, well, you have to do application first, get all your information before we allow you to see the home. Now, where do they do that at? They said they won't even let you come there unless you submit the application that they want to send to you via email or something to get your information. And then you send the application back to them, and then they allow you to come visit, tour the home. Rule 101. If it sounds fishy, more likely it is fishy. Point blank. So I just gave them a thumbs up and laughed at them. And then I looked at some more places, and I was looking at it how I was laughing at how people really think people are that. I won't say slow or stupid, but people are vulnerable, especially when they are in need and they're really looking for a place to live or rent. You know, things went up. They may want to move to a different location, and they're looking at these locations to move. And it is going on all around the world, not only in the United States, but over here in Mexico as well, as I told you before. So you have to be very careful about renting places or going to places where the deal may seem too good to be true. I'm going to play something that they posted a while back on a local news talking about how you can identify scams. And this, too, may help some of you guys who hadn't had the opportunity to see this video when you're pursuing trying to relocate or rent a property, or maybe even purchasing a home. So watch this video or some of the tips that could help you, and I'll catch you guys on the next video. I appreciate you watching, as always. Until the next one, bye now. Peace, one love.
If you are searching for a home or an apartment, there are a number of good apps and websites to help you with this process. But even though these apps and sites may be reputable, the people posting the ads could be scammers. Here are some telltale signs of a rental scam. The ad seems too good to be true, with promises of a great location, lots of amenities, and a lower than expected rental price. The landlord will only communicate via chat or email. Prior to viewing the property, you are asked to pay a large deposit, provide banking information, pictures of yourself and family members, or other personal information. And you are not allowed to view the property in person, often because the landlord claims he is out of the country. To avoid falling victim, do not provide personal information nor pay a deposit until you have viewed the property in person. Also, take measures to verify that the person offering the rental is the legitimate owner or manager of the property. And do not rent a property without getting a signed lease. If you suspect a scam, report it to law enforcement, the Federal Trade Commission, and the app or website so that the ad can be taken down.